Microsoft Access 2010 now supports something that's known as Table Macros. Table Macros are found under the Table Tools tab in Microsoft Access 2010 and can enable you to add commands that will control the behavior of the tables when you're inputting information before the change is committed or after the update takes place. In this lesson, we're going to look at an example of creating a macro that will automatically change a column in a table when another column is updated. For example, when we have a column in our table that is marking a task as completed, we would like the percentage completedness to be updated to be 100%. We can do that by using some of the actions that are available to us in the action catalog. For example, we can use the if-then condition, and we can use the set field command so that we can set a certain field to be equal to 100% when the status of the task is marked as complete. Let's take a look. In Access 2010, you can build table macros. And the intent of this example is that when I change the status of any one of these four tasks from not started to completed, before that change will be committed to the database, I want a macro to automatically change the percent complete. To do that, up on the Table Tools area of the ribbon, on the Table tab, I find that there are two groups of macros, those that take place before and those that take place after. In this case, I'd like to create a macro that will take place before the changes are committed to the database. And so I'll click Before Change, which will take me to the macro editing window. And there, I'll add a comment by double-clicking, and I'll put in my comment that this is going to automatically change the percent complete column. And in order to affect that change, I'm going to create an if statement. So I'll double-click on the if action, and in the if action, I'll say that if the status column of my table is one that is recognizing completedness, I want the percent complete column to mark 100%. Now, as I begin to type the word task, you'll notice that it automatically recognizes that I do have a column that's named task status. And so I'll press enter, and then I will then add the action that will take place if the task status is equal to completed. And I must type the word carefully between quotation marks. So I'll choose set field on the right side in the action catalog. And I'm going to do the following. I'm going to change the field that is known as percent complete. I'm going to change that to a value of 1. Now, because the column is marking percentages, 1 will be reflected with 100% complete. And that's the end of my if statement. If I'd like to add an else if for other conditions, I can. But for now, I'm going to close this window. And when I save my changes, I'm hopeful that if I change the status of that second task from started to the word completed, when I tab to the next field and then tab to complete editing this record, you will notice that the status changes to 100%. If I go to the next task and change that to the word completed, when I press tab and then complete the editing process by pressing tab once more, it automatically changes to 100%. Why is that the case? It's because I created a macro that's going to take place before the change is committed. And the macro is designed to change the percent complete to a value of 1 if the task status equals completed. That's a table macro in Access 2010. In this lesson, you've just seen an example of creating a table macro, a macro that will act whenever a value is changed in one column to update a column elsewhere in that table, a new feature in Access 2010. Thanks for watching.